But AIDS now is airborne, so we all gonna die in a month. So everything that you just said is a moot point. Give it to me.
I made you flashcards.
I'm a happy idiot and I review movies. And
Sierra Burgess is a loser.
Popular guy is a cheerleader for a number and she gives him Sierras instead. Rather than just, I don't know, being honest, Sierra catfishes him for most of the movie pretending to be that cheerleader. Remember how I got mad in my Flavors of Youth review because the guy wouldn't just talk to the girl he liked? This is a whole movie of that, except worse since she's actively lying to him. If that wasn't bad enough, she's also a pretentious douchebag.
Dickens. Too obvious.
So you want to go to Stanford?
Yes. I almost got a perfect score on my SATs. It's flu season. You should really wipe that on your elbow. Frodo is from Lord of the Rings. You're thinking of Quasimodo, the Hunchback of Notre Dame?
All the dialogue in this movie is trying to be LOL XD random, so all the characters talk like this.
You kids should be happy that I'm giving you some place to channel all this teen angst. Most of you just sweat feelings.
I'd say the movie's funny to not funny line ratio is about 2 to 1,927, which is also my KD in the Battlefield 5 beta. Luckily, I'm about to have Dragon Quest 11 to play. If it's bad, I'm coming to your house. Yes, explain, you better lock your door. Now, you may be wondering who that popular guy is I mentioned at the beginning but didn't show. What fearless whippersnapper would boldly approach a cheerleader and ask for her number?
Is that Peter Kavinsky?
That's right. Big Papa Kavinsky has blessed us with another appearance. And he sucks now.
Bonsoir.
Mademoiselle, good day, fair maiden.
I love football because every game is like a story. You know, for a few hours, there are villains and there are heroes. Every pass is a triumph, every tackle is a tragedy.
My favorite part of the movie, by far, is when the other characters realize that Sierra is an asshole.
Just stay the hell away from me.
Please tell me that wasn't you.
Come on, you hate Veronica.
Sierra, that was just wrong.
I saw you kiss him.
Well, he thinks I'm you, remember? That was the whole plan. No, you whine about your looks, but you have no idea what it's like to be me. I told you things I haven't told anyone. You think I'm mean? You should check the mirror, because your looks are the least ugly thing about you.
But I do admire the fact that this movie tried to bring back the timeless phrase, white girl wasted. And this scene reminds me of a track meet I went to back in Texas. On our bus there was this arrogant asshole that had never done hurdles before bragging about how he was going to come in first. We arrived at the meet and he refused to stretch because he was, quote, too good to stretch, unquote. When the race started, the hero immediately fell in the first hurdle and tragically broke his arm. But then the absolute mad lad got up, sauntered to the finish line, and the crowd ironically cheered for the brave soldier. After he finished, a girl with a Hello Kitty backpack ran up to him and handed him a band-aid. You know, to heal his broken arm. And just so we're clear, that totally wasn't me, cause that'd be embarrassing. Anyway, to get back to the movie review, in my movie review video, the directing is bad, the editing is nothing special, and I'll never remember any of these characters. They're godless sodomites and should be destroyed. The cheerleader Veronica is alright though. I kinda wish the movie was about her, to be honest. This scene summarizes how I feel about the movie pretty well. Oh yeah, the ending is terrible and makes me want to end my own life. I also need to tell you that I watched the movie twice to make sure I didn't miss anything, and I'm now irreparably emotionally damaged. I mispronounced irreparably, probably. I probably mispronounced it twice, but I'm going to keep going. I also think this movie somehow gave me a cold. Please donate to my Patreon so I can get better and get the medicine me and my family need. It may look like an obscure YouTube video, but it's totally my Patreon that I've never mentioned before. Like and subscribe. I'll see you on Friday if I don't kill myself. I will kill myself. Don't tune in on Friday. I'll be dead. I'll be dead. If someone's here, it's not me. Bye.
I'm a sick fuck. I like a quick fuck.